there's a little, you know, dirt going on about your girl. Have you seen this story right here? The Tamron Hall Show story?
Oh, I did, but do you believe it?
I don't know. So y'all know Tamron Hall, right?
Yes.
Tamron Hall Show is being called out again, this time, Nina, by our friend, Dr. Ian Smith. So Ian Smith was doing an interview, and he accused black-led daytime television show Tamron Hall of refusing to book black experts unless they're trending for something negative in nature.
Mm.
Basically saying if they get experts on the show to talk about a particular subject, they're getting white experts. But if it's something negative, then they get black experts.
Wow, what an accusation.
Yeah. There are a whole lot of people who look like me who are equally educated, equally articulate, who are not getting a platform on major shows. And you know, they won't bring on African-American or Latinx people as experts to talk about things like education, sociology, medicine, or law. Basically saying, Tamron Hall's show, if you black and you an expert on education, sociology, medicine, or law, she's not bringing you on the show.
Mm.
What?
Mm.
Yeah, man. They will only bring us on when we're an entertainer or athlete or we do something scandalous. Yep. Wow. Isn't that crazy? Yeah. He said he found it necessary to call out the show because we would definitely be doing so if the host was white. We'd be saying something about that. And here's the crazy thing. You know, shout out to Dr. Ian Smith. That's our buddy. You know, he went to Harvard.
Right.
So he's a highly educated brother. He's really smart, written several books. So he would know what he's talking about.
Mm.
Wow. Mm. Okay. While, of course, he did not mention Hall specifically, the person that was doing the interview assumed he was referencing the veteran television journalist because, well, there aren't but so many black hosts in daytime TV space right
now. Wait, hold on now. He never said her name. They're just saying that he's talking. That's not cool.
Well, he said it was a black daytime talk show host. Who else is on there?
Yeah, but if you're going to make those sort of allegations,
Nina
I would
Brown,
want
who else is in there? Well, I want to talk about that black girl that's on the show with Frank Ski in the morning.
I'm just saying, that's a heavy
allegation. I'm not going to say no names.
And I would want to see receipts. Like, show me an email.
So you
going to
think they're not talking about you?
I want to see an email thread where Dr. Ian was trying to get on the show and they were like, no, then they booked a white doctor instead. And you got to say her name. If you're going to insinuate that there's a black daytime show host who is, you know, blackballing black experts, then you got to put the name out there. What purpose is it if you're going to dance around it?
She kind of like the interviewer cornered him in it and said, who are you talking about? Was she formerly on cable and then moved to NBC and then moved on to her own show with her name on it? And Ian Smith smiled and nodded. He didn't say her name, but he said,
Well, let's call Ian.
You see, Nina Brown, you see?
Let's call him. We have his direct number.
You acting like, you know who you acting like?
Who?
Kamala Harris. That's exactly what Kamala Harris is. United States isn't racist, but we got to talk about the racism.
Not even the same thing.
The role of racism in the United States.
That's totally different. If you're going to accuse someone of doing something like this, this is bad. Then you have to come with it. Say their name and put the receipts out there.
Listen, okay, let me back up for the people in the back that might not have heard what I said. This woman who was interviewed with Ian Smith says, is it a she? Was she formerly on cable and then moved to NBC and then moved to her own show with her name on it? And Ian Smith smiled and nodded. And then she said, Tamron Hall. You heard it.
I'm gonna call Ian. Don't worry about it. As soon as we go to break, I'll call him and just to clarify. Because you sound like the guy who called into the show yesterday talking about the tequila.
What more clarity do you need?
Him to say, yes, I'm talking about Tamron Hall. Because that's a black woman. If you're going to throw a black woman under the bus, at least call her out on it and show me receipts.
If somebody called here and said, that girl, this real tall, she's Samoan, she on your show?
They could be talking about.
Are you talking about Nina? Is she? They nod their head. Was she on another radio station with me too? Did she used to manage at my restaurant? She been with me for like 15 years. She just had a baby. Who the hell else are we talking about, Nina?
Well, if you're going to throw me under the bus, come with the receipts, okay?
Oh, my God. Okay.
I'm going to call Dr. Smith, Dr. Ian Smith, as soon as we go to this break. In fact, let's go to the break.
Hey, G, you see what's happening here, right? If it was, check this out. If it was about a guy.
No, that's
she'd
not
have been
true.
Like, you see? Boy, you stick up
you
for women.
You have a black man throwing a black woman under the bus, and if you're going to make allegations like that, then you need to be specific and please come with receipts. We live in a world where people are falsely accusing people of doing things and ruins their career. That's not cool. If you're going to accuse someone of doing something,
been on television forever. He would not say that unless it was true. He's not going to risk his career.
But you're going to potentially damage another black woman's career?
Well, excuse me.
It's an allegation.
She's damaging black people's careers. That's the whole story, that she's not bringing on black experts.
It's an
allegation. Like, she's bringing on white experts.
It's an allegation.
Okay.
And if it's a personal thing, that's my point. Then you need to come with the receipts.
Okay.
How about can people call in about this? Because I want to know how everyone else feels. Maybe I'm looking at it wrong. But
He said, I'm putting this show on blast because when white shows and hosts don't let us on, we criticize them. But the same criticism has to be held when a show is helmed by and hosted by black people that keep us off the airways. It's just not right. So he's calling out. He's calling it what it is. Just because she's black, don't give her immunity.
Absolutely not. But while you're damaging a black woman's career, please come with receipts. Show me the email thread where you wanted to get on the show, she denied you, and then she booked a white guy instead. Just show me. Because I'm not just believing everything that people say. And okay. I know how media works.
Ooh, boy. Okay, I'm going to leave that one alone.
Let's call Dr. Ian Smith and see.
All right. So I do want to point out something.
Yes.
And here's what I'm going to point out. I got to keep it real. Now, you remember when they did the Wendy Williams?
Yeah.
Everybody watched the biopic of Wendy Williams. Remember when she does show prep? She goes into that room and the producers are in there and they're all in a room talking. So it's not like Tamron Hall doesn't know. You get what? Tamron Hall is smart. She got that position because she is a black woman in power. She didn't get that position because we needed a black face to take over after Steve Harvey. She got it because she was a black woman of power that could take over for Steve Harvey. You know, take over with Steve Harvey, that spot that he had. So she's got a lot of power. So if it's happening, you know, maybe she feels like she doesn't have power, like she's going to lose her show or have a voice. Maybe she does. But to say she doesn't know, I'm not going to accept.
Well, I mean,
maybe she doesn't have the power.
Exactly.
But I'm not going to say she doesn't know.
You and I have worked for people where we got, like, we would suggest people to come on the show or have an expert, and we were told, no, we're not going to do that. Or straight up, like, there was someone above us who would have the right to say, y'all aren't doing that on the show.
Which is true. Which is true. So we're both agreeing. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be the only show in America to talk to Dr. Ian Smith. We good? Is it ringing?
Yeah, it's we're ready.
Hey, buddy, it's Frank Ski.
Hey, Dr. Ian.
Hey, guys, how are you?
All right, so you've been getting the calls, huh?
Well, you know, I am actually touring right now for my new book, Fast Burn, that just came out. So, yeah, I'm all over the country talking about my 20th book. You know, helping people lose weight. It's been very successful. People are getting dramatic results and fast burn. So I've been getting calls, yes.
And let me preface this by saying Dr. Ian Smith is one of the few people, anytime he has hit my phone or Frank's phone when he's in town promoting a book, we book him without question because he has to be one of the most articulate, professional doctors that we can use as a resource, as a expert. So let me just say that you've been one of our go-to people, Dr. Ian Smith.
And let me be very clear also. I appreciate you guys for always giving me an audience and a platform. It's helped millions of people when I talk about weight loss or COVID or whatever. So I really appreciate that. And I want to make it clear that while I'm talking about fast burn and the 9-week program and all the great things that the book is doing for people to help them lose weight, I want you to know that there are other people, African-American people like myself, who are equally qualified, who are great experts, who also should be giving an audience also.
Now, we were talking a little bit earlier about the interview you did on Karen Hunter's show. And, you know, now, obviously, because it's you and it was about a black woman's show, supposedly, there's been a lot of, you know, uproar about it. But what is the word that you really want to get out to people about what is going on in the industry when it comes to booking black experts on television?
I am consistent that African-American, Latinx, and other ethnicities are equally capable of being pundits on major platforms and smaller platforms across the country. I'm an advocate for there to be diverse voices and faces to speak about issues, not just when something scandalous has happened, but also when something positive has happened. We want a legal expert, a medical expert, an education expert. African-American, Latinx, and other ethnicities are equally competent to be able to get on these platforms and discuss that. And I hope that everyone else who's in charge of letting us on their platforms will continue to let us do that.
Dr. Ian, just to be real, because I know this is what our listeners are thinking as well as myself, have you reached out directly to her just to have a conversation one-on-one?
I haven't made any direct accusations about any particular person. I've not named any person. What I have said is that shows need to have African Americans on, and shows need to give us a chance to be able to, look professional and relay our expert information. I'm not trying to single anybody out. I'm not trying to get into a public spat. I'm not trying to be inflammatory. We're in a time of racial awareness and awakening. And I'm just trying to say that during this time of racial awareness, we need to look at all issues as it regards to us and what's fair and what's not fair.
So okay. In this article where it says that, like, the person pulled it out of you and you smiled and nodded when she said Tamron Hall's name, is that not true?
Listen, I'm on the record for what I said, I don't want to get involved in pointing fingers and, you know, and those kind of things. That is not what I'm trying to do. What I'm trying to do is shine a light that we need to have more audience. I'm in the middle of a book tour,
yeah,
talking about, you know, fast burn. So I'm trying to, you know, that's what I'm actually really talking about. And that's the highlight of what I'm trying to mention to people. But I'm not trying to bring anybody down. I'm not trying to, you know, once again, I am consistent that African Americans and Latinx people deserve to have a voice at the table. And we deserve to have a voice when we are being presented as professional experts and being respected by everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that white people are willing to listen to black experts, just like black people are willing to listen to white experts. And that's all I'm saying is I think fairness is very important for all of us.
I agree with that 100%.
Same.
So when are we going to get to talk to you about the book? You going to reschedule with us?
Listen, well, I would appreciate next week. Let's try to help people lose some of this COVID weight.
I need help.
Okay. So I'm gonna call you guys, and then next week we do something on fast burn. I appreciate that.
How about it? Thank you, man.
Thank you
for your transparency, bro.
Love you.
Too.
Take care.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah, he said Entertainment Tonight, everybody.
Yeah, but he didn't really honestly answer the question that I asked, like, did you say it?
He said he didn't say it.
He said, I'm on record for saying what I said.
Yeah, what I said. And I read what he said. He didn't shout her out. But we knew he was talking about her.
Right, but that's not cool.
So,
we can't,
you know what? We
got to
do another show.
Okay, yeah.
We got to do another show. And we got to figure out, if a black person does something wrong, how do you deal with them without throwing them under the bus?
Yeah.
Because as soon as we start talking about somebody black, it's like we're throwing them under the bus.
Go to them directly.
Black people can't take creative criticism without, throwing me under the bus.
But at least you can say, I called Tamron directly and I told her this is how I feel. Mm-hmm. And so now that I'm saying it, understand this has already been said to her directly. That's it.
9:17. Nina Brown has spoken.